Hello, let's do some math for fun. Here we are going to find a solution to the equation e to the x that's equal to ln x. And you can expect that the answer to this right here is not real, because if you graph ln x and e to the x, you will see that e to the x is like this, and ln x is like that. They will not cross each other, but one good thing is that, you know, they are the inverse of each other, right? Anyway though, the challenge is that, can we find a complex solution to this? And as always, please pause the video and think about this first. And then today we have this guy. Okay. All right, so this right here is actually inspired by one of the recent videos that I did on Mu Prime Math's channel, so you guys go ahead and check that out, where I said that if you have the function that's equal to its inverse, you can actually just set that to be equal to x and then solve it. But unfortunately, that does not give you all the solutions every single time. However, it will give you all the solutions every single time if the function is increasing and always increasing. Yeah. But the worst part here is that they don't cross each other. So that method is still going to work, but I'm not going to go in there. Right? Anyway though, hopefully you guys have a chance to try it. Now, here we go. Let's see how we can do this. So, started with e to the x, that's equal to ln x. Yeah, perfect. Then I'm going to just look at e to both sides so that this and that will cancel. Perfect. And you will see that we can write this as x has to be equal to what? Well, e to the x, isn't it? Great. So that's what x is. And this reminds me what I just said earlier, if you put this is equal to x. But anyway, I will do this approach, right? Because actually I did the similar approach in one of my video with the square root and all that, so you guys go ahead and check that out if you would like. All right, here we go. X is equal to that. Huh, so have a look. X is equal to e to the e to the x, right? But isn't x just equal to e to the x, e to the x? Well, if I write that down again, I will put down e to the e, and this is e to the e to the x because of this. So you see, x is equal to e to the e to the e to the e to the x. But hold on, because if you would like, you can look at this x right here as the blue x, which is still e to the e to the x. And of course, I can put this down right here. So you will see that this right here becomes e to the e. And then we have two more e in red, and then we have two more e in blue. But you know, I'm going to put down the x right here. But you know, this procedure can keep on going forever. So you know, you can actually just put down dot, dot, dot. So in another word, x becomes what? Just e to the e to the e to the e to the e, infinitely many e's. Wow, wow. The truth is that this right here does not converge. All right, so you have to pay attention to if it converges or not. Anyway though, we are not doing real mathematics. We are doing complex mathematics, so we can go to the complex world. So have a look. Well, what's e to the t to the older stuff? You know, e to the e to the e, da da da, whatever, this right here is equal to x. But if you pay attention to just this portion, this is still e to the e to the e infinitely many times. So this right here is still equal to x. So in another word, we can look at this as e to the x, that's equal to x, like this. Yeah? Good. And now, how are you going to solve it? Take the natural log of both sides? No. Otherwise, no, just no. We actually have to use the Lambert W function, and this is how we can do it. Let me divide this on both sides. I'll just divide this by e to the x, like so. And you will see the left-hand side is 1, and the right-hand side becomes x, and I'll write this as e to the negative x power. And the purpose for me to do that is, here we have negative x. The base right here is e. This is x, which is almost the same. I just need to have negative. It's okay. Let me just multiply the negative on both sides. And then we can apply the Lambert W function. So let me do it here, and let me also do it here. And when we do that, the left-hand side will just give us negative x, right? Because the Lambert W function of this and that will just end up with this. And the right-hand side, I'll put this right here, which is just the Lambert W function of negative 1. And then I will just divide the x on both sides. You will see, divide the negative on both sides. You will see x is equal to negative W of negative 1, like this. And it looks like we only have one answer, but the truth is no, because you actually can go to different branches of the Lambert W function. If you pick 0 right here for the principal branch, you will end up with approximately, again, it's a complex number, so I'll just write this down. You will end up 0.318, yeah, that's the real part, and then you minus 1.337i. Anyway, hopefully you guys all like this video. I'll see you guys next time. And as always, that is it. Oh, he doesn't have a hand. Oh, anyway, bye.